Presentation.
Herzlich willkommen. Mein Name ist Jörg Winter und ich bin leidenschaftlicher Verkaufscoach.
Welcome. My name is Jörg Winter and I'm a sales coach. And I'm glad to present you today a few new thoughts. My presentation will be called How to Improve Your Sales with Engagement and Sustainability. Customer engagement means, first of all, how can I make my customers become regulars?
Und vor diesem Hintergrund möchte ich Ihnen gerne ein Bild auf den Weg mitgeben.
So, and before that background, I would like to give you a picture that will hopefully remain in your mind. Let's talk about the lifetime customer. Imagine you have a timeline ahead of you over many years, and all over these years, your customers are coming and selling. And now to realize the economic aspect of that topic, please ask yourself, how valuable is your customer? How much do I earn with him along the way? Let's calculate a little bit. Imagine a customer comes once a week. He spends, let's say, around about 12 euro per week. That means over the year it's a 624 euro and 10 years later 6,500 euros. In 10 years only with one customer. This is what means engagement to the customer. How valuable is he? And now imagine the customer comes into your business and before you there's a person who has a value of 6,500 euros. All of a sudden, he appears in a different light before you, doesn't he or she? And please keep that thought in mind and think how you can achieve that long customer binding. So you must offer him or her an experience, and I really say experience. What is this all about? I will tell you that now. So first of all, how can you make more customers come into your business? The second question, so when the customers are your customers, how can you make them into paying customers? And we want to know how can we increase your sales number. So, and if everything went good so far, the last impression counts, because this is really important. The last impression someone has matters. So, and then, after all, we will now take a look at a customer who is not satisfied. That is, when we take a look on the long-term customer relationship, not a good thing. So let's start. Okay. So first of all, increase the number of customers who come to your shop. So go on the street, take a look on other shops, lean back and then take a look on your shop. How? What does it feel like? Is it attractive? Makes the people curious, or is it rather boring, ugly? Is it clear what products you offer? If you are too emotional now because it's your shop, your heart and soul, go ask your friends, ask acquaintances, ask customers, ask them, hey, what do you think of my store? How is it? Then, when you take a look at your shop, think, what are obstacles to make customers come to my shop? The classic downturn is a small aisle.
So,
leave more room for the people to come in. And the last few years, I was starting an experiment with a few customers. We have complete emptied the shop windows so that those who were passing by could look inside, could see what's happening there. And without any exception, all of my customers said the customers were very happy. There were a large number coming in, more than before. Okay, a little decoration, a nice decoration in the shop window is of course good, but if they can look in, even better. So, and to get more customers, there is a third point that's very important to me. How do I get to my customers? And this is in a close connection with my opening hours. Customers need reliability. They want to know, when is my favorite store open? And talking about customers' relationship, customer engagement, it's also important to be available via telephone. The phone is still one of the most important things to keep in touch with your customers. So make sure that they can reach you on a professional level. You stop customers, you destroy the relationship to the customers if you do not take the phone when it rings. An answering machine is the minimum. Or even better, that everybody who works in your shop knows they always should take the phone when it rings. Make sure that someone always picks up. And you will see to increase or to stabilize the customers coming to your shop. That's important. And if you see there is still some fine-tuning necessary, make another look and see what is stopping the customers from coming to me, and then do away with it. Point two is to make visitors to my shop paying customers. Now let's start with a classic. So if I hear around among my friends and acquaintance, I hear from many people that they feel like overlooked when they are in stores. I wanted to make some test purchases and really, I was overlooked by the staff. So make sure that you see your customers, that you are there for them. Because customers who leave money by you in your shop, they don't want to be overlooked. And make sure that each one of your staff is friendly to every single customer, that he says hello, don't ask the customer questions, how can I help you, etc. That's in the first contact step. It's too much. The people do not want to answer questions. They would like to stand there, look around. They want to be welcomed, but they don't want to answer questions. First of all, maybe they would like around. They would like to look around on their own, and after that, they have questions. So watch the customers, check, try to find out if they have questions. Then you can go to them and ask, are you any questions? Can I help you? That's a friendly gesture. That makes you better than your competitors. Listen, be there.
Wirken Sie ansprechbar. Auch das sagen uns immer mehr Kunden in Gesprächen.
And many customers have told me that they would like to turn to the sales staff to ask, for instance. But that means, vice versa, that your staff needs to be there and the customers should always be able to find someone who they can talk to. So why does this not work? Well, one of the points is the staff maybe does not wear a uniform or not a little sign with their name upon. Or they are distracted, that the service staff is distracted because they are right now dealing with other things. They are, for example, working in administration things at the computer, etc. That's not good. Please show the customers, I always pay attention to you, no matter what I am working at. So this makes a difference. The customers feel that in the best case. So then the customers come in, we are getting in contact. So how can we increase now the sales? Have the courage to demand higher prices. Don't let intimidate you by discount offers. You have a store, a special store. The customers do not come to buy at your shop because they are looking for low prices. They want to feel service. They come also for you. They want your products. Price doesn't matter. I've just had a talk with one of my clients, and she said one of her most important customers is always entering her shop, her store, because they are looking for their collection. It's a very high-class collection. And this is what she offers. And the customers, a lot of customers are buying the expensive products. And the satisfaction of the customers is increasing. So the most important thing for you, of course, about satisfied customers are your sales. So just try it. Take a look on how you present your products. In your sector, the stationery branch, of course, the manufacturers also deliver and offer you some roll-ups and advertisement documents. But you also can contribute to a good presentation. So, imagine you would organize a party in your store. You know, usually in at a good party, a main point is also good food, of course. And you must, like this, present your product so that the customers are longing for buying them. Present them with a seductive style. You can learn how to do that in presentation, product presentation workshops. And please think of additional sales possibilities. So there you are wasting so many chances. Imagine you being a guest entering a restaurant. The most restaurants in Germany do not think of additional sales. There's only a small number of restaurants who ask anything else, can I help you? You, being a guest, you have to say, I would like to order something else. And that's the same in your store. There are so many possibilities you are losing if you are not in contact with your customer. Try to make him buy and think. The two of you are having something. He is happy with his product, you are happy with your sales. So, well, now you could say, all this, what I have heard, I've heard that before, but How is it? You come to your shop every day. You are doing the same. The goods are always similar to what you always offer. But do we really see the entire picture? I have discovered that pretty picture, and I recognized myself and many other people too. So, the fish, if he would describe himself, he would say, I'm a fish with beautiful eyes, beautiful body, and then in the mirror, you see only a glimpse of it. You catch only a glimpse of it. So what does that mean for you? So what's the real truth? Well, we make a change of perspective. Watching, looking into the mirror means we can slip in the shoes of the other one. So what can we do? When we see the entire great thing now, we see the customer. Please close your eyes and get into your business and ask yourself, why do your customers come to you, especially to you? That's a very important question. Of course, you can say, okay, they need some gifts, they need stationery, pencils, etc. Oh, there are many people. They are coming for you. Imagine that nice lady here. She needs the products you sell. But in the mind and the heart of that woman, something else is happening. She thinks, for instance, the occasion she needs your products for. Maybe some time ago she discovered lettering, let's say. So she wants to take time for lettering. Maybe she has a new friend she's exchanging letters with. So she has an idea in her mind. And please bear in mind, customers buy ideas. I mean, of course, we cannot get into the head of that woman, so we do not know what she's thinking. But what we can do is offer our products, present our products. So if we want to wake emotions in that woman, then we have achieved our goal. Let's think of the pupil. He is thinking of school, maybe happily. Well, the person we see here, rather not. But anyway, he needs information. He needs stuff for the school. So all the things he puts into his satchel. This is for him school. And now, when he comes to your shop and when he has the impression that you are interested in him, that he can talk to you about his school experiences, his teachers, for him, that's a great experience. Okay, I know, you may think, okay, if I spend so much time with every customer, I will not sell at all. By the way, talking about school, someone is entering your shop and says, do you have books for children to learn? And you say, yeah, we have. And then that's it. But you could also ask, why do you need these books? And she says, oh, my child is starting with school. And then she remembers maybe her first school days, and she read books for children too at that time. So that's such an emotional topic. And when we now ask for the child, that's great, that's totally different. Then you can sell so many other things, because it's not about sales only, it's about showing interest. So here two are coming and are looking for a gift. They have no gift ideas. She's open to everything, he does not even want to shop, you know that. So looking around, you can ask them, you get along well, or what do you need the gift for? Maybe she says, oh, we have someone who has a chubbily. And then you can open them, even him, because you are talking to him, you are interesting for him. Now here we have a young man, he wants to play. That brings to my mind how to contact young people. Over the last few days, I had a lot of video workshops. And it was also about young people. And I asked, how do you buy or where do you buy your products? And he said, not in the shop. And I said, oh, why?
Ich habe jetzt in diesen Wochen einige Videoseminare durchgeführt, Verkaufsseminare.
And I said, why don't you buy in the store?
Sonst ihre Sachen ein, da sagte er, jedenfalls nicht im Geschäft.
And then he said,
es war jemand, der in einem Laden arbeitete.
Many people think I am younger than I look, the young man said, and they treat me like a child.
Und ich fragte, woran liegt es denn?
Because I realized that the sales staff talks to me in a higher voice, as if I was a little baby. They treat me like a child. I wondered, could that be true? And then I got feedback from my family and friends, and they said, yes, exactly. The children said they do not treat us as if we were grown-up customers, but they treat us as if we were children. But young people want to be treated like grown-up customers. And that's a chance for you. So one more time, here we have a young man who is working at home office. Then you can ask him concrete, so are you already used to home office? Make small talk. Then, of course, you have the mega topic. It's about do-it-yourself. And now when you take a look at all this, you see there is such a variety. Your offer of products is adequate for all the variety of people. There are so many individuals. It's about humans. It's about persons. It's not about products. It's about relationships. You do not sell products. You sell ideas. And finally, one more time, ask yourself, why do the customers come? This is why they come. They come because they see you have a passion, they have a passion, you are interested in them. So, what to do to make your customers spend a good time in your shop? They have a good time, and in the end, they buy. So, and here one more time, you see our time board. And you see, you start selling to young people, and over the years, when they grow up, they still buy at your shop. Well, so have you so much more than just a business, just a store. You're offering fun. So you see, this is all that what you offer. You share happiness. You are a source of inspiration. You sell a warmth. You always have an open ear to the customers. You offer solutions for problems. You have so much more than just a shop. The most wasted chance for a long-term customer engagement is additional sales do not work. Maybe because people do not like the word. I myself had in a stationery shop an experience. I wanted to buy a card. I was at a funeral, and I had then the card when it comes in the case of a death. So the customer did not see that I was under emotional pressure coming from the cemetery of a friend. And he asked, can I offer you something else? I did not know what to say. I mean, these learned tries to sell, to make additional sales, they don't work. Encourage your customers. There is so much inspiration, there are so much associations.
Sie ermutigen ihre Kunden, sie motivieren sie, sie denken für sie mit. Denken sie an diesen riesen
Start Fantasies, decorate. You know so much more than your customers. At least this is what you should sell. So impossible your customers to buy more than they wanted to buy. So an important thing is the last impression counts. Make sure you are always in touch, and when he leaves, when he pays, you say, good luck or have fun with your product, or you can say, see you next time. Never forget, you want to make that customer a regular. I remember I was in a restaurant, and when the waitress asked, everything all right? And I say, okay, this is something we know. But then she asked, will you come back? And I thought, I've never heard that before. That was real interest, that the waitress would be happy if I came back to that restaurant. That surprised me, and it always gives me a possibility to give her feedback. So always have a focus on that final moment of the customer contact. Doesn't cost money or time and is helpful. So finally, the last point, critical point, unsatisfied customers. There are a lot of books about it. There are so many publications on that. I know customer management. But it's not a management or how to deal with unsatisfied customers. It's also, that's also negative. It's not about techniques. It's about people. And an absolute no-go is to tell one person like the other. Customers want to find a solution. They want you to find a solution for them. This is a point where you decide, does the customer beg or not? And there is only one way for you. Be open-minded, be generous. If you show into the future, you know that if this works here, the customer will come back. But if you make him feel that do not want to be generous, you do not want to help him, then he will never come back. So let us make a resume. It's three important things that matter. The customer who comes to you all life long. Become his first choice. So let's wrap up. Let's make a resume. So what matters to build a good customer relationship? How do you make him to think of your store, of if he needs to buy something in the stationery industry? It's a doubtful compliment if a customer says, I've been to so many shops, no one could help me, but you did. Second point, customers buy ideas. Be curious, be interested in them. Get their stories out of them. And then price doesn't matter. They just feel good and have a great experience. And then you have so much more than just a business. How do you talk about your shop? You just say, I sell stationery or other products. Think, people are making, when they come to you, that's for them like a break, like a short vacation.
So,
Because just think, if your customers are personalities, individuals, so be individual, be special to them too. And now let's talk about sustainability in products this time.
Und wenn Sie Produkte in Ihrem Sortiment haben, dann erwähnen Sie sie häufiger, als Sie es bisher getan haben. Sprechen Sie von den Naturmaterialien.
We talked about customer relationships, but engagement also means sustainability, and this is of course about products. Create images in the minds of your customers. If you sell sustainable products, say how special they are, the raw materials, the natural raw materials like wool, paper, wood. Talk about their longevity. That explains and justifies higher prices. More and more customers accept that. There is a new word, it's called upcycling. That means to reuse material. So if you sell these products, explain to customers what's the extra value for them if they buy. And then there is a point, let them touch, let them feel the products. So they see how special the materials are. And then that will give you in the long run a good image that makes you look better than your competitors. And that's your USP. Today we talked about selling ideas instead of products. And now it's your task to set new ideas in the minds of your customers. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your time. I hope you will be successful with your tips. And I hope we meet in person one day. Thank you, your Jörg Winter.